Now today we'll continue this video with the previous video, that is called chapter number 2, basic accounting terms. In the previous video we already discussed the basic terminology that is related to capital, business transaction, event, then liabilities, and liabilities into two parts, internal and external liability. So in the coming slide we'll continue with the liability part, but before that let me take the quick revision of the liability part only. So in the liability part, I told you what do you mean by liability, the amount which the business owes to outsider or which can be paid by the firm to the outsider, that is called liability. Liability is further divided to two categories, internal liability and external liability. Now what do we mean by internal liability? Internal liability means which the firm or business entity has to pay to the owner or proprietor. So that is considered as an internal liability, and the liability which the business entity has to pay to the outsider, that is considered as an external liability. So this is all about the liability, that is internal and external. In the coming slide, liability is further divided into two categories, that is called non-current liability and current liability. Liability is further divided into two categories, that is called non-current liability, and second one is current liability. Non-current liability means the liability which fall due for payment in relatively long period, that is called more than 1 year. We can say debentures, loan, that is all are a part of non-current liability. But what do you mean by current liability? So liability which are to be paid within a period of 1 year, that is normally 1 year, or we can say in the current year only. So that is considered as a current liability. For example, bills payable, or we can say creditors. So these all are an example of current liability. So non-current liability which is to be paid for a period of more than 1 year, and current liability are those liability which is paid within a 1 year. So this is all about the non-current liability and current liability. So liability is further divided into internal and external, and after that into non-current liability and current liability. In the coming slide, we'll discuss about the asset and the various part of asset. So here is the asset. Asset is means anything which is in the possession of the business and which are the property of the business. And we can say the amount which is due to it from others, like debtors and BR. These all are considered as a part of asset. So we can say in short, that is the property of the business or the things which are in the possession of the business, and the amount which is to be recovered from the others by the business is all are considered as an asset. Now asset is further divided into two parts, that is called non-current asset and current asset. So first let's start with the non-current asset. Non-current asset means anything which is used for producing the goods and services and which is purchased not for resale purpose. Is it clear to everyone? So this is all non-current assets. So I am repeating one again here, that anything which are held for continuous use for the purpose of producing goods and services, and anything which is purchased not for resale, these all are non-current assets. So example of non-current assets are long-term investment and fixed assets. So in the next slide we'll discuss about the definition of fixed assets and the types of fixed assets. So here is the fixed asset and the types of fixed asset. As I already told you in the previous slide, that fixed asset is a part of non-current asset, means those assets which are held for continued use, or we can say which are purchased not for sale purpose. So these all are non-current asset, and fixed asset is a part of non-current asset. Now fixed asset is further divided into two categories, that is tangible fixed assets and intangible fixed assets. Now come to the first part, what is tangible assets and what are the examples of tangible assets. Tangible assets are those assets which can be seen or touched, or in other sense we can say those assets which have a physical existence. So the example of tangible fixed assets are land and building, plant and machinery, furniture, because they have their physical existence and they can be easily touched and easily seen. So this is the tangible asset and the example of tangible asset. Now second one is, that is called intangible fixed asset. Intangible fixed asset are those asset which cannot be seen or felt or touched. It means, or in the other sense we can say, those asset which do not have any physical existence. So if we compare these two, tangible and intangible, so tangible means those asset which have a physical existence, and intangible means those asset which do not have a physical existence. So this is the major difference between tangible and intangible. The example of tangible fixed assets are land and building, plant and machinery, furniture. These all are tangible fixed assets, or motor vehicle we can say. Or intangible asset examples are goodwill, patent, trademark, recipes, formulas. These all are the example of intangible asset. So these, there are two types of fixed asset, that is called tangible and intangible. So if we take a revision of the asset, asset is further divided into two parts, non-current asset. The example of non-current assets are fixed asset, and the types of fixed asset are tangible and intangible asset. In the next slide, we will discuss about the second type of asset, that is called the current asset. So current assets. Current assets means those assets which are meant for sale, or we can say which the management can convert into cash within a period of 1 year. So those assets which are easily converted into cash within a period of 1 year, or which are meant for resale or sale, so that is considered as a current asset. Current asset is also called as short-lived or active asset, or we can say circulating or floating asset. So example of current assets are like debtors, BR, stock, cash, bank balance. These all are the examples of current asset. So this is all about the parts of liabilities and the parts of asset. So this is the end of the video. Thank you so much.